everyone, Renz here. Welcome back to my channel, the Mind Gears channel. I am delighted to share with you again this morning another insight about how we're going to manage our virtual teams. As we all know, everybody now is doing the virtual strategy to manage our teams, especially those who are actually working from home or those who are remotely working. So today, we will be talking some essential things that we need to apply in managing our team. We call this virtual dynamics. Understanding virtual dynamics is very important for the team because you all know that our team has different kind of skill sets, different kinds of attitude, different kinds of education, different kinds of understanding and experiences. So we need to know that each of our people remotely working has different kind of ability to cope up and to understand our instruction virtually. In virtual team dynamics, it is also the same as we used to in traditional way of managing people. We need to know and to check who among these people has the capacity to survive and to cope up with your instructions. Also, it is very important that all of your people met together virtually. They need to know each other. They need to have what we call a camaraderie for them to work as a team. Though they work remotely, it is still a must that all of them must have a collaboration and must have the same goal to achieve. As your teams become acquainted with each other, they can develop the synergy and the cooperation that is very important in attaining our goal. This will also remind them of individual tasks and roles that they need to accomplish in a certain period of time. With this, you can assure that everybody is aligned to whatever direction you want them to bring. In virtual dynamics, it is very essential as well to find out who among your people has the strength and has the weaknesses. If you discover that one of your people has the talent in a certain field of areas, make sure that these people can use the talent in a specific task that you give him. Also, identifying, motivating, and delegating a certain people in a certain task can really make all the virtual dynamics effective. This will hugely affect the productivity of your team. And as you define the weaknesses and strength, it's now easy for you to place him in the right role or position. By then, you can assure that everybody is really doing the right thing at the right time at the right place. In team dynamics, it is also crucial to identify who among your members are unsociable or introverted. We need to check this for us to be able to give our support to make them happy and to define their contribution in the team. As a leader, you need to be comfortable in adapting different types of personas. Sometimes you need to be a cheerleader of the team. Sometimes you are a friend. Sometimes you are truly a dictator. Sometimes you are a judge. And sometimes you are just a coach and a mentor. So here are the skills that you will be needing to really manage your team effectively virtually. Understanding team dynamics means to say that you need to understand the basics of management roles. You must understand recruitment and induction. Third, we need to evaluate team effectiveness and motivation. Fourth, it is important to develop and coach your team. Number four, it is really very important to coach and mentor your team. And number five, coping with challenges is vital for a leader. And number six, we need to realize the different management situations where our decision making will be challenged. In understanding the basics of management roles, you need to identify and to check how is your management level right now? How is your weaknesses and strength? Because you will be needing this assessment for you to guide your people properly and effectively. Go down to the level on what is the level of your patience, of your dedication, of your hard work, and most especially, how are you ready for the challenges and struggles that you will be facing as you're gonna have these people with you expecting the best coming from you. These insights will help you understand as well your strengths and weaknesses. By then, I believe that you can manage your team with different types of characteristics and expectations. Understanding your management roles also entails you to check once in a while your strategy and approach on how you're going to manage your team virtually, because it could be daunting on how you're going to be effective in your strategy now that you're leading your people not in a hands-on strategy but virtually. In team dynamics, creating a good relationship among your team is very important. This is crucial. You need to check your balance and perspective. It's easier to manage people who can get along with each other. This will give a clear viewpoint on how each one of them can work together to be effective as a team. An effective team invites many viewpoints, so make sure that you can use their differences in creating a very creative and innovative world for them. In team dynamics, it is very important the process of selecting and developing your people. Make sure that you have selected and filtered the right people in your team. Make sure that they are qualified to do the team and that they are ready with the resources that they will be needing, especially when it comes to gadgets and their internet connections. Developing the needed skills in your team is a very important part of the team formation. Finding new great members of the team is essential for team dynamics. This will help you provide a good team formation in the long run. Managing discipline and dealing with conflicts within the team is one of the important aspects also of team dynamics. Despite the instructions you gave, despite the proper supervision, still, we experience different types of struggle and different types of conflicts among our team members. As leaders, we need to deal with it promptly. If we don't discipline, a short mistake can affect our customer service situation. Not disciplining may impact and may give negative results to the total output of the team. It may damage how we provide best experience to the clients, especially when we are in the service of the client. This will hurt the team in everything the team has accomplished. Disciplining and managing conflict is a hard task to do, but you need to be patient, you need to be encouraging, and you need to be caring. Effective recruitment and induction is also a big part of team dynamics. When we induct our people, make sure that we have set all the norms, all the rules, all the system, and all the approaches that they will be doing to cope up with the new job. As a new member of the team, the leader should really direct the new people in your organization. Always remember that the future of your team depends or lies in the people that you have. You need to train them, you need to lead them, you need to coach them, and you need to remind them of their duties as a part of the team. Each member must be given a task and scope of responsibilities to follow and to execute in the coming days. Investing in a new talent or a new member of the team can be expensive or time-consuming. But don't hesitate to refill or to do the pipeline for those in your team who are not actually performing. This pipeline or pool of talents is essential for us not to defer the growth or the goal that we want to achieve in a certain period of time. So better yet, we need to continue recruiting and we need to continue inducting the new members of the team. Team effectiveness and motivation is also essential in team dynamics. Trying to figure out and trying to evaluate each performance of your team in a certain period of time will give you a data that you will be needing to innovate, to reflect, and to change the system that is happening at the moment. Changing and coping with the innovation is a good task to really check and evaluate the performance of your team. Collect, track, and respond to this data and identify the key indicators to success. When we identify key result areas of success, we can assure that everybody is doing the right job and we can actually correct the wrongdoings and the wrong system that our team members have committed. Tracking progress requires you to understand how your people is doing its time. we need to check if they're actually coping, following, and doing the right job one at a time. Are they responsive? Are they visible? Are they effective? Are they doing the right job? It is important as well to involve your team members in data collection so that everybody can feel that they are part of progressing, of innovation, and of changing. Having the right people in your team with the right skill is not sufficient for you to attain your goal. Leaders must know how to delegate things to maximize their time. You must invoke trust to the people which you think has the capacity to perform the job even without you in the process. Most of these skills an experienced leader does it on their own. We need to do delegation to make sure that the team is being managed not only by yourself. This will also help you to manage your team successfully and freely. Make sure that we trust people in the team, that just a minimal supervision, everything can be done. In virtual dynamics, motivating people is very essential. We need to check the situations of our team, how they're doing, what they're doing, and how they felt about the previous days that they are doing. It is very important to check the level of their satisfactions, the level of their emotions, the level of their situations at home. Motivating people relies on the principle touching a heart before they can lay a hand. Meaning to say, you need to make them feel that you are concerned, that you are there to guide them, that you are visible, and you are just willing to wait, and you are just willing to help at any point of time. So there we go. Hope you learned from me today. So all of us, being a leader of the family, must integrate this kind of strategy at home. This will ease the transition. This will help you also to make a flow in the zone that the world is giving us right now. Thank you for watching me today, and hope you are again inspired with me with this team we call Team Dynamics. Thank you for supporting my channel, and thank you to all the members of Team Sueño Family and the Mindful Club. See you again. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel. My name is Trent Stitches, saying, if you are safe, your family is safe. Hi everyone, welcome to my channel, Our Remote Working Age. Eight risks, or whatever they are.